To all the Kohanim, we hear again in Siman Kuf Kafchet, Halachot Nesiot Kapaim. This Halacha today in Seif Hei is actually about taking off the shoes before saying the Nesiat Kapaim, before giving the Bracha Birkat Kohanim. It says in the Halacha, Lo Ya'alu HaKohanim LaDuchan BeMinalim, Aval BePatei Shokaim Shaarei. One is not allowed to go up to Birkat Kohanim with his shoes, but he is allowed with batei shokaim, which means any kind of covering that is not shoes, socks, for example. A kohen should not go to do nesiat kapaim barefoot without socks because people look at his feet. It's not respectful. That's the reason also that they didn't allow shoes. The Gemara says that it's a takana of Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai, shelo ya'alu hakohanim laduchan b'na'alim b'na'alaim shal raglehem, that Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai was metaken, established that a kohen should not go to do Birkat Kohanim with his shoes. Ben'alaim, b'min'alim, shal raglehem. What's the reason? The Gemara deals with that. It's Gemara in Sota. And the Gemara over there says two reasons. Sota, daf mem, en ha-kohanim roshayim la'alot la'duchan b'sandaleem. One reason is, mishum kvod ha-tzipur. It's disrespectful. Why? Because sometimes the garment of the Kohen is picked up, you still have long garment, and then you see the shoes, and the shoes would be muddy from the outside, from the street. It would be disrespectful. That's one reason. Second reason, says the Gemara, we're afraid that since shoes have laces, maybe the lace would open up. And now he would, since it looks funny, people would start laughing at him, so therefore he would start tying it up in the middle of Birkat Kohanim. And people would say that the reason is not osek, involved with the bracha itself, but rather he's tying his shoes, is because he's not a kohen, he's really a ben gusha, a ben chalutza, he's a kohen pasul. It would bring him a bad name. And therefore, they were mitaken that one is not allowed to go to do Birkat Kohanim with the shoes. Now, these shoes that chachamim were mitaken, even if they don't have laces, because they didn't differentiate between shoes and shoes. They said, any shoes, even though it doesn't have laces and it doesn't have the problem that we just spoke, still should not be going up and say Birkat Kohanim with it. But there are places that we found that people go to do Birkat Kohanim with the shoes. How is that possible? How is that permitted? It's not permitted. But says Chacham Ovadia Nechaved Dat, that those that go up to do Birkat Kohanim with the shoes, although they're not doing correctly, one should not rebuke them. Why not? He brings few poskim. For instance, there's Rabbi Yeshua Prache HaKohen in Shut Veikra Yeshua that it says that only Birkat Kohanim with taking off the shoes is only when a Kohen goes up to the Duhan. Duhan would be a certain stand that a Kohen would go and raise himself up in that stand. And then everybody would be able to see his shoes. But today that everybody makes Birkat Kohanim on the floor in front of the Hechal, there's no stand that goes up normally. Therefore, such a thing is not in the Takana. This is also how it's brought down in other Sfarim, Rav Yitzchak Palaji, in Sefer Efel Alev, that the Shliach Tzibur, he says, that does not remove his shoes. It's fine. Why? Because he doesn't go to the Duhan. He doesn't raise himself up. He's right there where he's saying Birkat Kohanim, so therefore he doesn't need to take off his shoes. Now, la'alacha, we don't go like those poskim, but in Talumot Lev, the Gaon of Eliyahu Chazan, huge posek, he brings down in Talumot Lev that those that go up like that, you should not rebuke them, anach lehem l'Yisrael, sheyesh lehem al ma sheyismochu. This is how also it was nifsak in Shut Yam Gadol, and this is how Chacham Ovadia brings Chaved Dat, Chelek Bet, Siman Yud Gimel, and therefore, although yes, they have to take off the shoes and remove the shoes, but those that don't, you don't rebuke them. Now, when you take off your shoes, we're going to learn that after taking off your shoes, you have to wash your hands. So therefore, it's very important that you take off your shoes before you wash your hands. Or, if it's just such shoes that you can remove after you wash your hands without touching the shoes, you just remove them without touching them, that's fine. When you remove the shoes, you have to put them in a respectful place. You can't just leave them in the middle. This is Bet Hashem. It's the house of Hashem. You're in a shul. You can't just leave them in the middle. It has to be in a respectful place, either under the table, under a seat, on the side, in a way that it's respectful. And then that would be the proper way to do Birkat Kohanim.